quality stems from is just culture. You know, go back 1,000 years, 2,000 years, just how humanity developed. It was always, you know, men being genetically bigger, stronger. There wasn't much discussion, you know, that happened. I guess if you want to take even as far back as, you know, cavemen, it was just the strong, the fast survive.
You know, humanity has always had this weird interest in, like, things like that. And even though we look back on the gladiators and say, it's crazy that the whole city would gather to watch someone get eaten by a lion, like, athletics is kind of the same way for us. Like, we will literally turn on the boxing match and just watch as people beat the crap out of each other, and people enjoy it, you know?
It's wielding power, and you're gonna decide when, hey, gold comes about, who's gonna get it? Well, those who can control it. And so for guys, well, we're in power, we're gonna stay in power. And you know what, guys, we work hard, therefore we deserve to be able to relax and play more simply because we work harder than what women do. Yeah, just misperception.
It's just the perception that people have on women. You know, we used to be looked down upon and, like, not be able to work and just be housewives. I feel like that just carry on in the sport world. Like, women weren't supposed to be athletes.
I played against a team when I was 12, you know, the dream team, and they were girls from all over the country that would come together a few times a year to go play baseball, and our team was terrified to play them. They killed us, you know, like, their pitching shut us down, like, they dominated us overall. Like, there's no difference there, but it's just how society views them that I think is the issue.
You had a whole period of time where women weren't allowed to play sports. And then it was, well, you can play these types of games, but, you know, it's keeping you know, the proper appearance for a woman of being, you know, demure. Imagine, you know, that first time when women decided, I want to hoop it up. No, man, this is guys. Well, no, girls can get out there and play. And it's been an evolution and in some senses a revolution.
Well, before Title IX, you know, that was my career playing. And I was very, very lucky. I went to a school, a college, Indiana University, that had women's sports. Of course, we paid our own way places. We wore our gym suits as uniforms. And the guys were playing in a multi-million dollar facility with, obviously, flying around the country.
I know that Title IX requires, by law, that women be treated equally to men. And I also know that there's a lot of ways around that, honestly.
So a lot of things changed after Title IX. I was very blessed to have the opportunity to play, and then I was very blessed to be graduating from college the year Title IX came into play, which allowed me an opportunity to go on, get my master's degree, go on and become a coach. At that time, females were coaching females for the majority of the sports because there was a lot of money involved in paying women coaches. When women were making more money coaching women, all of a sudden the men wanted in, and the men came for the money, and so men started coaching women, and now it's really lopsided that more men are coaching female athletes at the college level than women are.
I mean, from personal experience, my coach now is a woman. You know, that's unheard of. We always go visit plays, schools, and they only have men trainers, men coaches, men everything.
Obviously, inequality, male-female, is rampant in our society, and we always say that athletics is a microcosm of society. So the way that we look at society in general, you know, we look at sport, and female athletes have always been a second-class citizen, regardless of what sport they're playing.
We, as women, we put the same amount of effort and time and dedication as men, yet, like, we don't get the same acknowledgement.
For the longest time, it has been, you know, men and men's sports coming first, getting the attention, getting the money. Somebody's getting slighted. Yeah, they're not getting what they truly deserve.